Dr. Maxwell Maltz was a prominent plastic surgeon who tells a story of a lady who came to him for help. Her husband's face had been burned and badly disfigured when he tried to rescue his parents from a burning house. He failed in his rescue attempt, and he assumed that God was punishing him because he failed. And he sequestered himself and refused to come out into public. And so the wife went to the doctor. The doctor said, "Oh, I can help him." And she said, "Well, he won't talk to anyone. So I'm wondering, would you do to me what the fire did to him? Would you so disfigure my face that when he sees my face, he sees a semblance of his, and maybe he will let me back into his life?" Well, the doctor refused, but he demanded an opportunity to visit with the man. And so he knocked on the door of the man's house. And he said through the closed door, "Your wife came to see me. She wants me to disfigure her face to look like yours so that you will welcome her back into your life." And after a few moments, the doorknob turned and the man opened the door. And he began to receive treatment and actually began a new chapter of life, all prompted by the incredible love of one who would become like him so that he would turn back to her. God did that for you, my friend. God did that for you. The scripture says that all things were made through him, and without him nothing was made that was made. He was in very nature God. He simply spoke and it happened. He made it all. This stuns us. But what really rocks our world, the incarnation. He, speaking of Christ, God, he made himself nothing. He made himself hungry. He made himself small. And as if that's not enough, even death on a cross. The one being crucified was tortured. He was whipped. He was often impaled. He was nailed to a cross, stripped naked. Why would he do this? Why? So you would know he knows what it's like to be you. He became like you with the hope that you would trust him and become like him. So he can redeem you and take you into an eternal home. He can help you face today's problems. If he can make the universe, don't you think he can make sense out of your life? Go to him. You do not have a God who cannot understand you, but one who has been tested in every way, just like we are, yet without sin. And so you can approach the throne of grace with boldness. Worship Jesus Christ. Worship the one who has the name above every name. Bow your knee before the one who is the only true King of the universe, and that is the name of Jesus Christ.